So everything we've done so far has been pretty limited, that we had to do the same thing on all data. We couldn't do anything that really depended on what the data was. So what we're going to do next is figure out a way to make code behave differently based on decisions. The first thing we're going to do is figure out some ways to make comparisons so we have a way to test and decide what we should do. So Python provides lots of different operators for doing comparisons. They're things similar to what we've used in math. We have a less than sign that compares two numbers. We have a greater than. We have a less than or equal to, things like this. All of these operate on numbers, so we can have a number followed by a comparison operator followed by another number. This is very similar to the grammar we saw earlier for arithmetic expressions, but now instead of having a plus or times here, we can have something that does a comparison. The output of a comparison, though, is not a number. It's a Boolean value. And a Boolean value is one of two things. It's either the value true or the value false. So let's see some examples in the Python interpreter. So first, we'll use the less than to compare 2 and 3. So 2 is less than 3, so we expect the result to be true. When we run this, we see that the result is true. If we compare a number greater than 3, let's say 21 less than 3, the result will be false. We can have any expression we want with a comparison. So we can do 7 times 3 is less than 21. When we run that, we also get false because 7 times 3 is equal to 21, which is not less than 21. Another comparison operator we can use is not equal to. So exclamation point equal means not equal to. So 7 times 3 not equal to 21 is false because 7 times 3 is equal to 21. If we want to do a quality comparison, we don't use the equal sign. We use two equal signs. We call that the double equal. So now we have 7 times 3 double equal 21, and the result there is true. So now we're going to have a quiz to see if you can figure out why we need to use the double equal here instead of just the single equal. So the question is, why is the quality comparison done using double equal sign, having two equals, instead of just a single equal sign? So the possible answers, because the single equal sign means approximately equal, and we want to do exact equality comparisons. Because we needed to use two characters for the not equal comparison, and we wanted the equal to be the same length. Because Guido, the designer of Python, really likes equal signs. Because the single equal sign means assignment, or it doesn't really matter. We could use either double equal or single equal.